Standing dark.
In the vastness of stars, what do you see?
An older guy has sauntered into Lucy's life, and some researchers believe he stands ready to recast much of what scientists know about the celebrated early hominin and her species. But there are researchers who are not so convinced that the new fossil changes much of what they already knew about Lucy and her kind. Fossils from the Awash River Valley in Ethiopia have pushed the existence of man's line back to before 4 million years ago, and this is the first time since the excavation of Lucy in 1974 that paleoanthropologists have turned up more than isolated pieces of an adult from the species, which lived in East Africa from about 4 million to 3 million years ago. Excavations in Ethiopia's Afar region have uncovered a 3.6 million-year-old partial male skeleton of the species Australopithecus afarensis. The team that discovered the skeleton was led by anthropologist Yohannes Haile-Selassie of the Cleveland Museum of National History and is dubbed the new find Kadanuumuu, which means big man in the Afar language. Partial skeleton of a male uncovered in Afar, Ethiopia was also known as Lucy's big brother. An arm bone was first found in 2005, and other parts recovered over the next 4 years included shoulder blade, ribs, neck, vertebrae, pelvis, leg bones, which included a complete tibia and partial femur and a collarbone. This individual stood about 1.6 meters or around 5 feet, 30% larger than Lucy. Excavations between 2005 and 2008 were in a part of Afar called Woranso-Mille, about 48 kilometers north of where Lucy's 3.2 million-year-old remains were found, and yielded fossils from 32 bones of the same individual. The shoulder blade looks more like that of a gorilla and a modern human than that of a chimpanzee, and the curvature of the second rib suggests a wide ribcage at the top and a barrel shape overall, similar to that of modern humans and distinct from the more funnel-shaped ribcage of a chimpanzee. Coming to how Lucy's big brother moved from one place to another. Well, Lucy has often been portrayed as having had a fairly primitive two-legged gait and a penchant for tree climbing. But big man's long legs, relatively narrow chest, and inwardly curving back denote a nearly human-like gait and ground-based lifestyle as published in some reports. Estimates of Lucy's build were based on comparisons to chimps and indicated to some scientists that she lacked the easy, straight-legged stride of people today. Haile-Selassie and his colleagues suspect that their final reconstruction of big man's anatomy will provide a better model for assessing what Lucy looks like. Okay, so we have viewed the fossils from the discoverer's point of view. Now let us view it from the opposing team's point of view. When news reports of a recent partial fossil skeleton find from Ethiopia's Afar region is set to represent Australopithecus afarensis, the same species as the famous Lucy, it was unclear to some scientists from the description of the fossil skeleton in these news reports of whether big man's assignment to the species Australopithecus afarensis has more to do with the alleged geological age of the fossil than its form. Besides other factors, they also spoke of the height. Said to have stood at 1.6 meters tall, about 30% larger than Lucy, they say it is well within the human range and considerably larger than Lucy. Anne Gibbons also notes the authors as saying that the curvature of the second rib suggests a wide ribcage at the top and a barrel shape overall, similar to that of modern humans and distinct from the more funnel-shaped ribcage of a chimpanzee. But Lucy's ribcage has been described as being conical-shaped, that is, funnel-shaped, by an evolutionary expert. Hence, they concluded that the difference in body size and ribcage structure indicates that Big Man was not an Australopithecine like Lucy, but more likely an ancient human. The scientists that didn't agree on Big Man being an Australopithecine also stated that Big Man is said to have long legs according to the founding authors, which is consistent with it being human. Therefore, they say, with the only relative complete limb bone being the left tibia, one has to be cautious about saying anything too definite about limb proportions. If all these were true, and if Big Man had been dated to around 1.6 million years ago instead of 3.6 million years ago, evolutionists would be talking about an early Homo skeleton, probably Homo erectus, and certainly not Australopithecus afarensis. I, for one, am still not used to these debates, guys. Tell me what you think of this discussion and drop a comment in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.